Hey guys, today we're at Darwin Military Museum located at East Point. I've come here before and I'm so excited to go in again. Let's go. We just got our tickets and because Mum's got an NT driver's license, we got a free yearly pass. So it looks like on my screen, it looks like it's people telling their stories of when they were in the bombing of Darwin, maybe? So it's people telling about their relatives or them that survived the bombing of Darwin.
My dear men and Ellen, it's after midnight. Things are not getting any easier. Business and work is increasing all the time. Mr. Bald hasn't been too good the last few days, and I've been trying to give him a bit of extra help with the trench at the back of his house. The depth is about 5 foot. Everyone says it will be safe from everything but a direct hit. It's where I'll be going if there is a raid. You mustn't worry about the hospital. Sweet dreams, my sweethearts, and loads of kisses and hugs to you both. From your loving husband and daddy, Arthur.
Gonna be a hot one. Too right it is.
What are you doing? Oh, thank you. That'd be nice.
So, what do you think of our chance today?
Oh, then we're going to get in the mech.
From Melbourne. Huge flight of bombers overhead, bound for Darwin.
Nah, it's probably nothing. It's just the Yanks coming back.
Explosion and the kangaroo was showered by shrapnel.
We just kept firing, and then it just went over us and kept him waiting out. Up his ass! Up his ass!
Everywhere I looked, there were jet planes.
The planes were that close, I could see the gold teeth in the pilot's mouth.
The whole building came crashing down. We dragged Elsie from the rubble, but little Daisy was nowhere to be seen. Poor Daisy was dead.
It was awful, devastating, shocking. It's a terrible thing to see men in burning oil screaming out for help, and you can't do anything about it.
Who survived saw my father running after the boat Neptuna, and it got a direct hit. They never ever found his body.
I knew her and I said g'day to her and talked to her quite frequently. And this was 9 o'clock. By 10 o'clock she was dead and I never saw her again. Personally and intimately the entire post office staff. I had the sad task of identifying 9 bodies as they lay outside the hospital.
That was good. Just like I remember, it was awesome.